today we are celebrating our annual scholarship luncheon, where today we'll be rewarding 18 high schoolers with scholarship as they go on to their collegiate endeavors and making sure that the citizens of Houston and the world are in a better place.
And it's just going to be a great day. We want to celebrate education, celebrate our kids. These are children of officers and civilians, and also some very lucky community members that rode in, and we awarded them with the scholarship. So again, really excited to be here. So proud of these young people. We have to support them going forward. So thank everybody. I want to thank everybody for being here today.
So without further ado, we're going to have some special remarks from a young lady that needs no introduction. She is very special to APOL, and she's always been a constant supporter of this organization, this scholarship, and the work that APOL is doing in the community, bridging the gap between community and police. So without further ado, I'd like to bring up our Congresswoman, your Congresswoman, Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee.
And so let me congratulate the Houston Police Department and APOL for the numbers that have gone down, Chief, in homicide, and the absolute stellar numbers that have been part of your definition. So today, to those who are receiving scholarships and to these families, take this as a pathway of their destiny, that there are people who are holding them up, that they're not alone when you make this journey. Whether you are a young lady or a young gentleman, you're not alone. Know that we've got your back. We've been there where you are, and we see you. And I think that's the most important part of this city. We need to see you. I'm a very long-standing member of the House Judiciary Committee. We deal with the laws of this land. We deal with criminal justice laws. We deal with federal law enforcement. So think of that. You can be at HPD, and you can see I have no fear. Didn't even jump. I know where I am. I'm protected.
Protected. Yes, sir.
But long years of experience with ATF, alcohol, tobacco, and firearm, FBI, DEA, drug enforcement, all of these, U.S. Marshals. If you want the best law enforcement, it needs to be you. If you ask what's going on in your community, you need to stand up and say, send me. Because you can make a difference. And so I want to congratulate APOL and all of the board members, all of the officers, Houston Police Department. We've got the best police chief we could ever have. Thank you, Mayor Turner, who is standing as a great giant. And so as I leave you today, if I can leave you only with the words, Lord, lift you up where the eagles fly. Always be above. Never try to get down and be somewhere where somebody's going to drag you down. You keep your eye on the prize, and you hope, know that we've got somebody, and there are wonderful parents in this room, grandparents, friends. Don't do it alone. Let them know. Give me a helping hand. Then they point you to somebody, and that person comes running.
But to all the scholarship recipients, I really wanted to be here for you all. So congratulations to each and every one. I have certificates, and when their names are called, we can do it all at that time.
Yes, sir.
But really appreciate what you all, what APOL is doing, all of the officers, and your contribution. Chief Fenner, thank you so very much.
I want to thank y'all. I want to let you know, the recipients, how proud I am of each and every one of you. When I left my mother's and father's home my senior year that summer, I think they had $237. Wow. That's all I had. That's all they had. But I took that, and with the help of other people, we got through. Yeah. And that's what I want from y'all, okay? I didn't get a scholarship from APOL or other places. You know, I had what my mom and dad had at the time, and that's all that they had. So just notice one thing here at this Houston Police Department in the city. You have all these leaders here. We all love you, and we're pulling for you. And academic excellence is something that we need to talk about more. Academic excellence. And I'm so proud that you're doing it, and we're going to be right here for you. But one ask I have, don't look past this police department. Everything's about recruiting, okay?
Yeah.
So when you get through with your degree, look back at us, okay? It's a great place to work. But I also want to thank APOL. all the board members and everybody to put this together. It's all about relationships.
Mr. Mayor, Councilmember Alcorn, Sergeant Love, APO leadership, but most importantly, to our scholars and your parents and your families, it is an honor to be here with you this morning. As I was thinking about what I was going to share with you, we just came through Juneteenth weekend. We came through, you know, Father's Day weekend, and so I was thinking about my dad's service to this city. But I was also thinking about, you know, Juneteenth is a celebration of freedom. It's a celebration of the advancement of civil rights. And I thought about the police's role in that. And the honest story is that police have been on both sides of the fight. If you think about some of the earliest police departments in the country, they were formed to round up runaway slaves. All right. But when you think about Juneteenth, it was law enforcement. What we're celebrating on Juneteenth is law enforcement showing up to the shores of Galveston, Texas, to enforce the laws of freedom in the United States. Go forward a little bit, you have Jim Crow. And you look at pictures from, you know, Alabama and Mississippi. You think about John Lewis crossing the bridge in Selma and being beaten and abused by police officers. But you also think about desegregation in our major universities, and you have law enforcement standing there to ensure the safety of young people of color who are integrating those schools. And so we have a choice, right? And APO is an organization founded by Officer Alvin Young in 1975. And Officer Young had obviously experienced some of the ills of racism right here in the city of Houston. And the early members of this organization, many of them grew up in a city of Houston where they were not considered equal. One of them was my dad. My dad grew up in Third Ward, just a little bit down the street from where I live today. And as a kid, he drank from colored-only water fountains. But as he got older, he was called to serve. And as Sergeant Hutchison mentioned, he spent 34 years of his life dedicating himself to making his neighbors safer. And the members of APO have committed so much to bridging the gap between the Houston Police Department and our communities, and ensuring that as we keep this city safe, that it's a vision for one Houston, Mayor, that there's not a different kind of justice on one side of town versus the other, or a different brand of safety on one side of the town versus the other. You mentioned my mom as well. My parents were my call to service. They were my example of what it meant to extend yourself and help your neighbor. Neither of them graduated from college. Again, as my dad put on a uniform, my mom, in partnership with my father, because it certainly took both of them, they offered a foundation to me and my two sisters. They pushed us to achieve our God-given ability. And then they offered that same foundation to kids they didn't even know. And so that's what I saw from a very young age, was my dad getting up early, putting on that uniform and going to work, and my parents serving. And many of your parents, you might be a first generation student going to college, but many of you have parents who have been there and are showing you the way. And I know that they love you and are committed to your success. I took that push from my mom and dad, and they pushed us, me and my two sisters. And even though they had never been to college, they sent all three of their kids to college. And all three of us got advanced degrees. And today, both of my sisters are teachers here in the Houston area. I was the rebel. I went off to business school. But whether it was in the halls of Morehouse College or in the halls of the Obama White House, I got to bear witness to people who had so much God-given ability, who could be doing anything in the world, and they were using their talents to better our communities, to better our society. And I sought to do the same thing. As a management consultant, I help government agencies to transform the way that they operate to better deliver on their missions, to better serve the people who they were called to serve, which is us. And again, in 2020, when we were in the midst of the pandemic, but we were also in the midst of what I believe to be the most important election of our lifetimes, I raised my hand to serve. Our county clerk had resigned for health reasons. We were in this pandemic. She was up there in age. And so she thought it best to step down because she couldn't afford to be a frontline worker. And so now in the midst of this most important, critical moment in our nation's history, in our state's most populous county, in the third largest county in the country, we no longer had the person whose job it was going to be to ensure that the election even happened. And I had never run an election. I'd never been part of election administration. I had held up signs and worn t-shirts and all those different things. But what I had done time and time again throughout my career was step into challenging situations like that, where there was a problem that we were facing that many deemed insurmountable, that some had already tried to address or to tackle and had failed. And we brought in new ideas. We brought in talented, committed people in the way that I had seen, again, in the Obama White House and other places. And we brought in services that were common sense. Drive-through voting. People thought that was a huge innovation. We've been driving through the grocery store, the bank, the pharmacy for 50 years. 24-hour voting, keeping the polls open late at night so that our first responders, so that doctors and nurses, people who were keeping us safe during that time, essential workers who were at the grocery store stocking shelves till 2 and 3 in the morning. We gave them an opportunity to vote in the same way that other folks do, which is a time that's convenient for them and their busy schedules. And through that work, and I won't even go into the political fights that we had to have to protect the right to vote here in Harris County, but ultimately we were able to ensure that nearly 1.7 million people could exercise their constitutional right to vote. And we made sure that every single one of those votes counted. Mm. Now, there was a man named Benjamin Elijah Mays, who some of you may have heard of, some of you probably not. He was an educator. And what he said, he was an Omega Man, Mayor. All right. Was that whatever you do, do it so well that no person living, no person dead, and no person yet to be born could do it any better. Wow. And Benjamin Elijah Mays had a mentee. His name was Martin Luther King Jr. And King took it a step further. Calm down, it's my speech. King took it a step further and he said, even if it falls to you to sweep streets, sweep those streets like Michelangelo painted paintings. Sweep those streets like Beethoven composed music. And now I know some moms in here who said, I told this boy to sleep and he ain't sleeping like no Michelangelo. But that's all right because you all are called to a higher purpose. Now you still gotta listen to your parents, but I was reading through some of your bios. And we have future doctors in the room. We have future educators in the room, future scientists in the room. At least one of you said you were going to be a police officer.
All right.
And whenever you're doing those things, set your own standard. Your professors, they're going to give you hopefully A's and A pluses, maybe a B, maybe even a C here or there. You have to not let that professor be the one who's dictating your future, your progress, your trajectory. You have to be that guiding light. Yeah. And you have parents who are going to hold you to a high standard. But you have to take it even further than your parents could have envisioned. And I know that's possible. And so, as I leave you, y'all are going to do some great things. And I'm so inspired by each and every one of your stories. How many years ago was this? 20 years ago. I sat in not this very room, but a room just like this, and I got an APOL scholarship. All right. And it helped me. education has gotten only more expensive over the years. And so let's give a round of applause to APOL for shining this light in our community and helping our young people to advance. But you're gonna have that moment one day. Hopefully we don't see another pandemic anytime soon. But when that moment comes for you, you're gonna know that it's that time. And at that moment, you gotta raise your hand and you gotta deliver. And that's why APOL is investing in you, because we know that sometime in the future, what you're gonna give back to this Houston community is gonna change lives. And so I wanna thank each and every one of y'all, our scholars who are going off to fantastic universities and colleges, institutions of higher learning. Y'all are going to be great, and I'm humbled to be here in your presence today. God bless y'all.
How do we help change the world? I'll ask that question one more time. How do we help change the world? The key is how we raise our children.
All right.
The key is how we raise our children. My name is Brandon Love, and I serve as the current president for the Afro-American Police Officers League. And I thank you all for coming out today. For those who are joining us for the first time, please allow me a moment to provide some historical context about the Afro-American Police Officers League. Since 1975, the Afro-American Police Officers League, affectionately known as APOL, has been at the forefront working with city lawmakers in Austin, city leaders, and the Houston Police Department command staff to bring about positive change in this profession. Policing in the South during the 1970s was no easy feat, especially right after the Civil Rights Movement. APOL founders, the late A.V. Young and former Assistant Chief Jimmy Dotson, found a need to create an organization to be the representation of the minority officer during such turbulent times. These two individuals founded like-minded officers who had similar values that inculcated in them to help make sure that the minority officer had a fair chance when it came to promoting within the ranks, fair treatment towards discipline, and fair opportunities to interview for specialized divisions, just to name a few. The work of APOL's fight for equality began to garner the respect of our peers and our counterparts and other ethnic backgrounds, which led us to expanding our partnerships. Today, APOL represents over 900 police officers and has expanded its educational and training citywide, which brings us full circle as to why we're here today. And I believe that is very deserving of a round of applause. We are honored to reward these 18 scholarships today. Each of you are special and well-deserving of it. Your future is our future. APOL prides itself on its diverse membership, serving not only those from the African-American community, but members from all backgrounds. You future leaders will make tomorrow better, and we as an organization will continue to lean on you as you continue to climb the ladder of success. So, to my future doctors, lawyers, educators, policymakers, public servants, entrepreneurs, and world leaders, we wish you well in your collegiate career, and we in APOL are confident that you will continue to be an agent of change and will remain steadfast in your goal to effectuate positive change in all of your endeavors. Thank you.
On behalf of APOL, each year we award thousands of dollars in scholarships. We are proud to support our future leaders with their educational goals. I will introduce each winner and read a short bio submitted by the recipient. In no particular order, some of the bios have been edited for time. Let's get to it. Our first recipient is Monet Ford. Monet graduated from Klein Forest High School with a 4.9 GPA and is listed as top 10% of her graduating class. Monet plans on attending Sam Houston State University with an anticipated major in education. Congratulations, Monet, you're getting $500 today. Next up, we have Caden Clark. Caden graduated from Michael E. DeBakey High School of Health Professions with a 3.5 GPA. This fall, he will be attending the University of Texas at San Antonio, majoring in physical therapy. After college, Caden plans on returning to Houston and opening up a physical therapy clinic that provides low-cost services to the elderly and senior citizen population of Houston. Next up, we have Madison Carter. Madison graduated with honors from the Fort Bend Christian Academy. Madison plans on attending Duke University in the fall, where she will major in biomedical engineering. Madison is grateful for her parents and her sister who have been supportive, loving, and so much fun to be around. You have been awarded $500, Madison. Next up, we have Isabella Trevino. Isabella graduated from Michael E. DeBakey High School of Health Professions with a 4.0 GPA. Oh, her mother is representing her today. Isabella plans on attending the University of St. Thomas with a desired occupation of a nurse practitioner. She has been awarded $500 today. Next up, we have Haley Scott. Where's Miss Haley? Come on, Haley. Haley graduated from Manvel High School in Alvin ISD. She is the only child to her mother, Brittany Scott. Haley has participated in various extracurricular activities from the marching band, swim, culture club, and soccer. After much encouragement and consideration, Haley decided to make Prairie View A&M University her next in matriculating her life journey. Thank you, Haley. $500 for you. Next, we have Liliana Montalvo. Liliana graduated from Stephen F. Austin High School with a 3.7 GPA. She plans on attending Sam Houston State University to study criminal justice and criminology. Liliana hopes to become a crime scene investigator or a criminologist after college. Congratulations, Liliana. $500 has been awarded to you. Next, we have Brianna Weber. Hey, Brianna, you carry my first name. Brianna graduated from Jack Yates High School with a 3.7 GPA. In the fall, she plans on attending Texas Southern University, majoring in child development, and she plans on working with hospitalized children. You have been awarded $500. Next, we have Adanola Ojo. I got to take my time with that one. Adanola Ojo. Adanola graduated from Harmony School of Innovation located in Sugar Land, Texas, with a 3.97 GPA. Adanola plans on attending Houston Christian University in the fall, majoring in computer science with hopes on becoming a computer scientist. Adanola has received other scholarships, including the Founders A Scholarship and the Academic Excellence Scholarship. $500 has been awarded to you, Adanola. Congratulations. Next, we have Carrington Houston. Carrington Houston graduated from Mickey Leland College Preparatory Academy for Young Males with a 3.54 GPA. Carrington plans on attending Texas Southern University with an anticipated major in business administration. Carrington's desired occupation is to become a real estate agent. Carrington graduated with honors and was also awarded for outstanding achievement both inside and outside of the classroom, along with being a proud Eagle Scout. Congratulations, Carrington. $500 has been awarded to you. Next, we have Janelle Adams. Janelle graduated summa cum laude from Cypress Ranch High School with a 6.6 GPA. Janelle plans on attending Baylor University, majoring in biology. That's what I majored in. Her goal is to become an obstetrician. Janelle was honored and received the College Board Outstanding Achievement Award, along with the AP Scholar with Honor Award. Congratulations, Janelle. You received $1,000. Next up, we have Allison Williams. Allison graduated from Summer Creek High School in Humble ISD, graduating the top 10% of her class with a 3.9 GPA. Allison has received a Louisiana State University Transformation Merit Scholarship and also a recipient of the Houston Police Officers Union Scholarship. In the fall, Allison will attend LSU with plans to become an attorney or an optometrist. Congratulations. Next, we have Paul Singleton. Paul graduated from Summer Creek High School with a 4.5 GPA. Paul plans on attending Trinity Valley Community College, majoring in communications. Paul plans on pursuing a career in law enforcement. All right, Paul. All right. Police officer, you police officer, HPD. $1,000 has been awarded to you. Next, we have Trinity Bird. Trinity graduated from Manville High School in Alvin ISD, top 25% quartile of her class with a 3.6 GPA. Trinity plans on attending Baylor University in the fall, majoring in nursing. Trinity was recently crowned the 2023 Manville Senior Prom Queen and is also a member of the Delta Sigma Theta Gym Academy. $1,000 has been awarded to you. Congratulations, Trinity. Next, we have Cameron Tien. Come on, Cameron. Cameron graduated summa cum laude from Pearland High School with an unweighted GPA of 4.0 and a weighted GPA of 5.423 on a 6.0 scale. The upcoming fall, Cameron will be attending Texas A&M University located in College Station, majoring in business. Cameron has attained several certifications, which includes patient care technician, EKG technician, and a pharmacy technician. Congratulations, Cameron. $1,000 has been awarded to you. Next, we have Brianna Brooks. There she is. Brianna graduated from Ridge Point High School with a 3.4 GPA. Brianna plans on attending Prairie View A&M University and majoring in nursing. $1,000 has been awarded to you, Brianna. Congratulations. Next, we have Sierra Wright. Sierra graduated from Klein Oak High School with a 3.5 GPA. Sierra plans on attending Lone Star College and Tomball, majoring in veterinary science. Sierra wishes to pursue a career in veterinary medicine of exotic animals. Sierra has participated in several programs, including FFA, Future Farmers of America, KISD, Livestock and Project Show, and HOSA, Future Health Professionals Organization, just to name a few. Sierra, in her free time, shares the love of horseback riding with her twin sister, Sienna. Congratulations, Sierra. You've been awarded $1,000. And last but not least, we have Sienna Wright. Come on, Sienna. Sienna graduated from Klein Oak High School with a 3.2 GPA. Sienna plans on attending Lone Star College in Tomball, majoring in veterinary science. Sienna wishes to pursue a career in veterinary medicine. Sienna has participated in several programs, including FFA, Prairie View A&M University Ag Discovery Program, REAP, Research Apprentice Extension Program, just to name a few. Sienna also, in her free time, shares love for horseback riding with her twin sister, Sierra. Congratulations, $1,000 has been awarded to you. This concludes our presentation for our class of 2023 recipients. Let's give another round of applause to our winners.